Today we're going to unlock this MacBook Air using the CMIzapper Medusa. This is a MacBook Air from 2011, I think, so it's a fairly old model. The Medusa connects into the speed port of the computer using this little easy flash adapter thing. It has a little connector on the back which fits into the speed connector on the motherboard. I had to remove the Wi-Fi card to make some space for the board to plug in. Let's plug it in. The Mac is powered from the battery and we see that the little light on the easy flash comes on, even though the Mac is off. And we connect the cable from the easy flash to the Medusa. The Medusa recognizes the ROM in the Mac and it starts reading all sorts of information from it. Serial number of the Mac, production date of the Mac, and as you see, it's locked. And the motherboard number, 820-3023. The first thing we'll do is copy the ROM from the Mac to the Medusa so that we have a backup in case something screws up later on. So to make the copy, we switch to mode 1. It sees the ROM chip and it starts copying. When the Medusa reads the Mac ROM, it reads it very, very carefully. So even if it would lose connection with the Mac, then it will still read the data correct. For example, if we disconnect the plug now, let's try it. You see it gives an error and it stops, but it's trying. It's trying all the time. And if we connect it again, it should continue where it left off. As you see, it continues and all is fine and dandy. There's no need to read the ROM three times like you would with a normal ROM reader. If the Medusa reads the ROM, you can be certain that what it reads is correct. If it is reading nonsense, it would stop and pause. Now we will try to unlock it. So we have to set the Medusa to the unlock mode. It's mode 6. Now, because it's writing, or it will write to the Mac, it asks you to confirm with the button. Most of the safe things on the Medusa happen automatically, but if it becomes potentially dangerous, then it asks you to confirm by pressing the button. Again, it sees the ROM. It sees that it's locked. It checks if it understands the firmware version. It clears the appropriate block, and now it should be unlocked. Now we disconnect the Medusa and we see if everything worked. To see if the Mac is still locked, we turn it on while holding the Alt key or the Option key down. And as you can see, we can now choose which disk to boot up from. The only choice is the internal SSD. but we get the choice. So this confirms that the Mac is now not locked. Thank you for watching, and I hope you understand a little bit more of what the Medusa can be used for. If you like this movie or movies like this, then please subscribe to our channel. We make many more products that are very useful for people repairing Apple Macintosh computers.